Thank you. Wind are in Oh, Dreams come true to me. If love. saw that truck and you smiled so wide. A real life truck in your driveway. We let you sit behind the wheel. Goodbye, goodbye. Now it's just me and my little guy. And the house felt so big. And I felt so small. The house felt so big. And I felt so small. That night I tucked you into bed. I will never forget how you sat up and said, is there another truck coming to our driveway? A truck that will take mommy away. And the house felt so big, and I felt so small.
To all our performers once more, please. Can I just take the time to thank our amazing accompanists tonight, Mr. Boyle and Mr. Shu, please. Our wonderful headmaster to come down and join us, and I'd like to invite our wonderful adjudicator Amy Dickinson to the floor. Come on forward.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for inviting me here to adjudicate tonight. This is a tough gig, to say any business, because my goodness, the standard here tonight. Singing of such a high standard. I just want to start. You'll see I've written comments, individual comments to you all, but just overall, generally, each and every one of you gave such engaging, committed, well-prepared, convincing performances and moving, and we all really enjoyed it and really, really well done. So can we just start again?
By
start with the prize for the junior vocal classical group. And this prize goes to Honor Francis. Musical theatre and jazz group. And this prize goes to Emma Wise. Classical. And this prize goes to a singer who I felt really gave a very stylistic and convincing performance, who just went that sort of extra way in really holding their own and being sort of a little bit braver tonight. For example, in just taking a bit more time in the rests to breathe, to be expressive, and there was a real range of expression here. And that prize goes to Amelie Waitling. Singers, you know, and it really is sort of hats off to you, because we're so exposed when we sing. We've got nowhere to hide, and it's really about being able to let go in the moment. Once the sound is out, it's no longer, you can't control it. It's you hand it over, you give it, you share it, and it takes a lot of courage. And a lot of time to prepare that and get used to that feeling. And I felt that a lot of you tonight really embodied the character within your songs. And to embody that, you kept in that character throughout. And that takes a lot of concentration and focus. And it was really impressive. I found that in this next category, the senior vocal, musical theatre and jazz, there were two winners. So this is a joint prize that goes to B. Patterson and Tansy Fowler. Displayed an extraordinary range of colour and emotion in their voice tonight, and also a real sort of technical command and understanding of style, and had also fantastic stage presence. And that goes to Tansy Fowler.
So this is the last of the Marmotti events for this year, which is an amazing achievement. I just wanted to pause for a moment to say a thank you, but also to try and put it in a bit of context. You spoke beautifully about that sense of exposure, particularly for the singers. I absolutely recognise that when you come out here to perform, you are giving something of yourself to the audience. And that is a beautiful thing that you do, and that you put yourself up for adjudication and competition is also a tremendous thing that you do. And that you choose to do it in the middle of the maelstrom of everything else that's happening during school life is incredibly impressive. And of course, there are winners, there are those that haven't won. I get that completely, but I hope that you sense that through being part of this competition, you have grown in your musicality. What I can certainly say is that I come along here, however often it is, once a week to these competitions, and if this is work, then I am very happy to have to do it. It is a source of huge joy and pride to me as headmaster of Millfield to see the standard that we are achieving, yes. But it is a greater source of joy and pride to see all year groups of the school represented in pretty much every category, actually, across the whole piece. And that thing about music in this school that encourages children of all year groups to be part of the family is something that's really important and really special. And so thank you for being a part of that process. I think that we have thanked Mr. Boyle and Mr. Shue, but I think that we should thank them again because my quick straw poll tells me that they have both accompanied somewhere in excess of 40 of you in your performances here on stage. And they do it not just like a backing track, do they? They do it in a way that supports you and nurtures you and takes you along on the journey. And they do it seemingly effortlessly. So can we give them a big round of applause? Educators, your teachers have supported you through this process. Your parents, God knows, they support you on this journey. They are part of the audience. They can never say the right thing to you at times, I know, but they carry on and they support you regardless. So I don't think that we need to pause and applaud them, but I think that maybe later you could take the moment to thank them, now that we're at the end of this process, for the support that they have shown you all the way through. And last, but by no means least, Sarah Grace has put this all together, and it is a huge, epic undertaking, and yet it seems so professional, so effortless, and so beautiful to those of us that get to watch it. So thank you very much for everything.